This is an update in my continuing coverage of the radio signal associated with the star Ross 128. It may be my last on this particular signal, as the mystery, at least on its face, seems solved, though questions do remain. This story has grown somewhat controversial and murky despite being apparently solved, though that may not be so clean-cut. In light of that, I'm just going to tell you what has emerged about the signal, why it was unusual, and then recount the aftermath of the detection, focusing on the actual science rather than the human controversy. The signal's frequency was at 4.6 to 4.8 GHz. This is not a good area for detecting an unambiguous alien signal due to the fact that it's very popular and advantageous for use in telecommunications, especially satellites. It's also a place where you find lots of other Earth interference sources. Because of that, this would normally be a signal that could be easily chalked up as probably just a satellite, and in fairness it was, sort of. But what set it apart was that it didn't act like a satellite. It would slide down the scale as far as the frequency, and then repeat, which was described as quasi-periodic, and it also showed evidence of dispersion, or as it was termed, dispersion-like characteristics. Dispersion occurs when electromagnetic waves cross the interstellar medium. Different frequencies travel at different rates through interstellar space due to a kind of refraction that causes a delay. I know that's hopelessly oversimplified, but the end result is higher and lower frequencies arrive at slightly different times, and that tells you that the signal has traveled long distance. That would suggest that this was not due to interference from Earth. So a second look, with Arecibo and a few other telescopes, seemed in order just in case. The Green Bank telescope observed the star, but did not pick up the signal. Link to the results of that observation in the description below. The Allen Telescope Array also made observations, but they haven't yet said if they saw anything, and reportedly, they were observing the star again today, even after the reported solving of the mystery. According to Abel Mendez's Twitter account, the main scientist investigating this, Arecibo did pick up the signal again. He said that the signal was there and then faded, and that would support a satellite as the cause. In a statement, link also in the description below, he said that the signal was almost certainly a geosynchronous satellite or satellites, of which a number were in the area of the sky around Ross 128. He continues to say that the dispersion-like features in the signal remain unexplained, and that they will continue trying to figure it out. He also noted the results of an informal internet poll they took regarding the signal and made observations on public willingness to accept an extraterrestrial origin for the signal, which consumed a significant portion of the statement. Much internet grumbling and eyebrow raising ensued over that one. Setting that aside, the statement pins the explanation down to satellite interference, and the dispersion, if that's what it was, remains a mystery. Unaddressed, as far as I know, were questions about why the signal was so weak, and why the signal slid down the frequencies. So there is the information that's out there for you to draw your own conclusions, because that's about all we can really do with this one, unfortunately. If anything else comes to light, I'll be sure to report it. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently looking forward to talking about space tardigrades in tomorrow's video. Yay! And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular, in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.